Let's say we're asked to find the domain of the function p of x equals the square root of 16 minus x squared. We start by recognizing that because we have a quadratic radicand, the usual approach of just setting the radicand greater than or equal to 0 is not going to apply. So we're going to have to approach this problem in stages. First, we'll just set the radicand equal to 0, and then we'll deal with the positive values, or the values that will yield a positive radicand. So we start by setting 16 minus x squared equal to 0. Hopefully you remember that this is a difference of squares, so I can factor this into 4 plus x times 4 minus x equals 0. Now by the zero product property, I know that either 4 plus x must equal 0 or 4 minus x must equal 0. Solving each of those equations independently gives us x equals negative 4 and x equals 4. That means that if I were to take those numbers and plug them into my original function, square root of 16 minus x squared, I'm going to end up finding the square root of 0, which is legal. I can find the square root or an even root of a 0. So above those two numbers, I'm going to put solid dots to indicate that those two numbers, negative 4 and 4, are included in the domain. Now what we need to do to figure out what else is included in the domain is to figure out for which values of x my radicand is positive. So let's do this by picking numbers in these three intervals. Let's say we pick negative 5. Now we can see that the square root of 4 plus x times 4 minus x is going to yield the square root of negative 9. We cannot find the square root of negative numbers. So we get a sad face here to indicate that none of these numbers will work out. If we pick a number in the middle of negative 4 and 4, say 0, 4 plus 0 is positive, 4 minus 0 is positive. If I multiply the two 4s, I get 16. I can find the square root of 16. I don't need to know what it is. I just need to know that it's a positive number, so I can proceed. Happy face, and this region is in the domain. Lastly, we pick a number to the right of 4, say 5. And if I plug 5 into my equation, I get a negative number again as the radicand. I can't do this. I cannot find the square root of a negative 9. So that gets a little sad face and a cross here. So that tells me that the domain of this function must be from negative 4 to positive 4, including both the endpoints indicated by brackets or square brackets.